Hello Librans, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you and your person. So on one side I'll be drawing cards for your energies, and on the other side the energies of your person. And feel free to swap your characters according to the story and then the most likely outcome. Okay, so let's see what's going on with the Librans. Okay, so on your side we have the strength. Let's see what's there on your person side. The five of pentacles, okay. Most likely outcome. Okay, the four of cups. Okay, so Librans, you are dealing with somebody, something or someone. So there's a situation in this relationship which is requiring a lot of patience over here. It's sort of taxing you, and it's becoming a tough deal now. It's taxing your patience basically. Something is there in this relationship, in this situation, which you're dealing with a lot of strength and patience. Okay. And here with the five of pentacles, your person feels ignored. This person feels rejected. Maybe you've done something. Something has happened in this relationship that this person is turning their back from you. Sort of, it's leaving. Because they felt ignored, and perhaps the response wasn't good, something like that. But definitely there is something, this person is feeling rejected and ignored, and that is why this person is leaving. And here is the most likely outcome with the four of cups. Reluctancy in accepting something new, because here you're upset and not accepting what the universe has to give you for some reason. Let me see what's there behind the cards before I comment on them. Let's see, why is this strength card here? Okay, so we have the nine of pentacles, the temperance, and the sun. Okay, why is this five of pentacles here for on the person side? Cards are flying, but somehow I don't take those cards. Okay, so we have the Hierophant, the Emperor, and the Fool. And the Fool card jumped up when I was seeing the cards were flying. Then at that time also the Fool card had jumped up. Okay, what's there for this outcome? We have the five of pentacles, the king of cups, and the four of wands. Okay, the eight of swords, the seven of wands, and the king of swords.
Ten of swords.
You have eight of wands, the ten of pentacles, and the ace of swords. Okay. So Librans, with the nine of pentacles, what I am getting here is that you were sort of enjoying your life alone, very happily enjoying all the luxuries which life had given you. It was, you were really not much bothered about anyone, sort of, okay, till something caught your eye. It's like till this bird caught your eye, or this relationship caught your eye, okay, and then you see, this is something which has caught your eye, this bird or this relationship, this person. So you were happy in your own life, basically enjoying your life alone, sort of, and then something different caught your eye, okay. And with the temperance, what I feel is that you are trying with the strength and the temperance, you are trying hard to balance this situation, but the thing is, there is a lot of intensity in your gaze now. You are totally focused on this, what this person, because we're talking about the relationship, you are totally, at this time it was very light-hearted, okay, it just caught your eye, you just liked it, it's fine, nothing serious over here, okay, it's you're just liking it, perhaps you're just liking it, you're like playing with it, sort of, it's getting, because you're enjoying over here, you're playing with it, it's like a bird you found and you're happy, but you are alone, not investing it, but you, it's just its presence is making you happy. Something like that. It caught your eye and its presence is making you happy. Okay, so you like the presence of this bird or this person. Something of like that. And here, with the temperance, suddenly something has happened that you've turned serious. I see you here very serious and very focused and totally glued to this person. And this is the change from this playful energy or light-hearted energy when you're not taking things seriously. Suddenly now you're serious. Serious and totally focused on that person. And here what I am getting is that though you were trying to make up your mind and juggling between two situations or to make up your mind, but now you are keeping that aside. You are coming to a decision here. What's I feel? You've stopped juggling. Sort of you were juggling it and now you're keeping it aside. Okay, leave that juggling part. It's coming like that. See, you are juggling it and now it's over. You've made up my mind. Yeah, that's what. So here it is a light-hearted energy in which you were just liking it, liking its presence. You just felt happy in it and you were, okay, nothing much to do. Just play with it. Happy with it. Not in a negative way playing, but yes. But now some things have got serious. You were not deciding or not... whatever you were doing, not making up your mind, but now you're just leaving that indecisiveness aside and totally glued, making up your mind. It's you're becoming a Meko man, sort of a thing. And with the sun, what I'm feeling here is that this is what you feel this person is to you. You are totally glued to this person. I don't know, I'm picking up the energy of the other person over here. But this is, you are, this person gives you happiness. This thing which you thought was light, was just making you happy in a, just a playful manner. You were not taking it very seriously. Now you're very serious about it because you feel that this person is your sunshine. This person gives you happiness. You feel liberated. You feel happy in the presence of this person. And the strength is because perhaps you were juggling till now and now you are sort of trying to make up that mind and you want it, sort of, you want this. And it's requiring a lot of strength for you and patience for you to make it happen. how to go about it, something like that. But you are definitely leaving aside this indecisiveness of yours. And here with the Hierophant and the Emperor and the Fool, wait a second, I would like to charge this camera before it gets discharged in between. Let me see what can be done. Wait a second, please give me a second. Because otherwise, I won't be able to record it. Yeah. So, sorry for the pause in between. Sorry for the disturbance. But yes, now we'll get back. Actually, the battery was going. So now, here with the Hierophant and the Emperor, what I am getting here is that this person felt left out and ignored. And this person was actually looking for a commitment from you. And it's sort of that you didn't give this commitment to them. And it's what I'm getting here is that this person is crying their heart out and feeling miserable. Whatever the Hierophant has in a traditional way, I'm not getting that vibe. What the vibe which I'm getting is this person was sitting there at your doorstep waiting for a commitment. And this person is looking up to heaven and crying as to, I love this person so much, and they're just not opening up, they're just not committing to me. It's something like that. And then when they were sick, and in what shape they are, just see the, they're really feeling miserable over here and just crying. That is the vibe I'm getting, not laughing. This person is looking up to the heaven and just crying as to feeling so miserable, what to do, sitting at your doorstep waiting for a commitment over here, but you weren't doing that. And now this person has left. That is what, with the Five of Pentacles, because you didn't listen to them, you didn't commit, you didn't open up, whatever. Howsoever you behave, you didn't behave in a good way. It's coming off as if it's coming off like a beggar sitting at your doorstep, and perhaps that person actually begged for a relationship. Perhaps this person actually felt like that when they were looking for a commitment from you. Maybe that is what you made them feel, as if they're a beggar. As if they're the only person who need this relationship. It's something like that. That is the vibe and the energy to it. This person felt like that, as if this person is begging you for this relationship. And here, when it was not given, this person just left. And with the Emperor, this is the self-work. This is the work they've done on themselves. That's what I feel. This is the work they've done on themselves. They've left. They've started focusing on themselves. They've started investing in themselves. Okay, so, and once they start doing that, this is the empowerment of energy, and this is the work they have done on themselves. That this is the vibe over here which I'm getting. They're pretty confident, empowered, not bothered. I am not budging. I will not do anything. I will not invest. I won't come to you. Simple. That's what that person has decided, and this person is sitting pretty cool out here. So that's what your person is doing. This person has now, you are looking at this person in such a way because they have worked hard on themselves. They have really empowered themselves now. Okay, they are pretty confident. They are not in this shape now begging you for attention or begging up for the relationship. And here with the Fool, one thing is, I think there is some beginning, new beginning may come up in this relationship, perhaps now, but this person isn't going to do anything because this person is sitting pretty cool now, and this person is ready to take, this person has just surrendered. That's what I'm getting. Okay, let's see what happens, sort of a thing. Okay, so they have begun a new life for themselves. They have made a new life for themselves. They are sitting tight. They have taken that leap of faith. Okay. Perhaps it was not supposed to happen. Okay, let life take me where it is supposed to take me. And this person has, they have totally surrendered to the situation, basically. That's what I'm getting. They want a new beginning in their life, and they are looking for a, see, they've turned their back from you, and they are beginning a new life for themselves. And they have surrendered to life, basically. They have surrendered to life, actually, that they are ready to take that leap of faith as to let life show them what actually lies ahead. something of that sort. Let life show them what actually is good for them and what is the right direction for them. It's something like that. Most likely outcome with the four of cups, as I said, because of the fact that you were reluctant, you didn't open up, you didn't accept their offer perhaps, and that is why they have left. That is what has come up. And here, as a clarifier, we have the five of pentacles, the king of cups, the four of wands. Eight of swords, the seven of wands, king of swords, the ten of swords. I have taken many cards, I know. See, what the thing is that again, you did not accept their offer, and here now with the five of pentacles, what I feel is now you are feeling bad about it perhaps. You are feeling upset behind these closed doors, but with the king of cups, what I feel is that this person can perhaps sense it, that you are feeling bad about it. They are, it's coming off as if they are looking from far. They are still, they have their eyes on you. They are looking from far, but they won't do anything because now they have done that work. They are, now you are feeling upset that this is what you've done to them, but this person, they have their eyes on you, but they are comfortable now. They just, it has that vibe when you see that person, okay, when I was there you didn't listen to me, when I was there you didn't accept my love, and now you are realizing it, and they know that you are realizing it. They are not over you. They know, they are watching a move, they have the emotions stirring between within, but they are eyes, they know what's happening behind the undercurrents. Okay, so this person is watching you from a distance, sort of a thing. Okay, and here with the four of wands, I see there is some happiness coming over here, some celebration, some victory, some happiness, perhaps reunion, perhaps you meet. So this person is cool and calm. Okay, one more thing is, maybe when you come to this person and you tell them this is how I'm feeling, and then they don't have any grudges. Basically they don't have any grudges, they will listen to you and accept it, whatever it is. And here then with the four of wands, I see both of you together. That's what this person is now, mature enough to understand and accept what you have to say and how you're feeling. So I don't think they are going to bother you with the fact that why you did this and why you did that, because they have mentally they have worked so much that they are mature and wise now. And one thing is, they are centered, very centered now, very centered and mature. And here with the eight of swords, what I feel is this is something which was stopping you from opening up. Perhaps this is how you felt. This is how you felt, that encaged, and now you are like sort of, you want to come out of it because you know that it is because of this, something was holding you back that you couldn't make a move. What I feel is that you have a very, I think this is the energy of the person, the who has, somebody here has a very withered type of a past, a very injured type of a past. This person is very hurt, have faced the harsh reality sort of life, had a very, very tough life. They have faced very tough seasons in their life with something like that. They really struggled, and a fighter type of a thing which I'm getting, from the basics with no, it is not giving me the vibe of, they have struggled a lot basically from the vibe. They didn't have enough resources sort of, and they really faced the harsh realities of life, and that is what perhaps was stopping them from opening up. But with the seven of wands, I think now they're turning their back from this negativity and trying to be centered, trying to focus on themselves, trying to find peace in within themselves. Perhaps because they couldn't open up because of the fact that they have faced the harsh realities, and now they have done that work or they are willing to do it and trying to make peace with their own life. Basically, that's what I'm getting. They're trying to find peace in their own life. And here with the Ten of Swords, I think this person is now ready to make a move, open. Basically, they're coming out of this negativity. The work which they are doing with the Seven of Wands, focusing on themselves, perhaps even praying and meditating, will liberate, give them that liberation from that negativity. And they seeing that life with a new perspective, and it's breathing that fresh air, is the vibe which I'm getting. Ready to make a move, looking towards life in a fresh way, in a new way over here. Okay, and here with the Eight of Wands, the Ten of Pentacles, a lot of communication is coming in, a lot of communication and perhaps a commitment with the Ten of Pentacles. Since this person has worked on themselves now there's a lot of communication and commitment will come in. That's what I feel. And here with the Ace of Swords and the Queen of Cups, yeah, see, what I am getting here is that now the thing is, now you are happy. That ecstasy feeling that now it's done, sort of. You're feeling overwhelmed and happy. Here with the Queen of Cups, very content, overwhelmed, happy. As to that finally you've achieved it, sort of. One more thing which is coming to me is that though you have got that commitment, though you have got this communication and all, but you are focusing on yourself. With the Ace of Swords, you're still working on yourself. You don't want anything negative there now. It's healing. That light is coming in your brain, sort of. Healing. And here with the Queen of Cups, here it is talking about contentment and ecstasy, basically, I should say. It's talking about ecstasy. So I think after this commitment comes in, you are feeling very happy and content and fulfilled, sort of. But one more thing is there with the Queen of Cups, which is coming to my mind, is that this person isn't going to make a move. This person is not going to make a move. Let's see what's the message from the universe. Consider your foundation. Number 50 or number 5 may be of some significance for you. Look at how committed you are to love. Here I see a house and a couple over here. And here we have the Ten of Pentacles. So I think the commitment is coming in. A stable, long-term commitment is coming in. Listen, to consider your foundation. Look how committed you are to love. Just see how much you want the other person. Okay. And if you really want the person, you have to make a move. So Librans, that's all I have for you. Hope it helps. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.